I'm Nathan from Pack Hacker, and in this video, we're taking a detailed look at the Patagonia Black Hole Pack 25 litres, which I've been testing for the last 2 weeks. Head on over to packhacker.com for the full written review, link in the description below. Let's dive in. Okay, so we will start off just by covering some of the materials on this bag. And as the bag's name suggests, this bag is made up of Patagonia's black hole fabric. And what that is a recycled polyester ripstop. And it's this kind of shiny stuff on the front with a TPU laminated coating. So it's really weather resistant. And we've had pretty good experiences with it in the past. We like that it's recycled. Patagonia does a really good job there. And personally, I'm not a crazy fan of how it looks, this kind of shiny material, but all in all, it comes together to look pretty good. And I know a lot of people really dig what Patagonia have with their black hole. So that's the kind of bulk of the material there. As you can see, they've got some branding, this Patagonia little label on the front here, which is actually gives it quite a nice little look. And the zippers are all YKK. See around here, which is great. Had some good experiences with YKK. Really solid zippers, should hold up. And then hardware wise, we have got Duraflex sternum strap here and buckles, and Duraflex, just like YKK, had good experiences with. And you know, you can't really ask for much more better hardware on a pack like this. YKK zippers and Duraflex hardware. So all good there when it comes to kind of materials. Looking at the front here, we've got this daisy chain, which I've just popped a little carabiner through, so you can attach a hat onto the front, something like that. It is a kind of urban-ish kind of day pack, but as with Patagonia, there's definitely an outdoor element. You can take this on the trail, pack it up with loads of stuff, and you're good to go. And this kind of daisy chain gives that away, and it's cool to add some stuff onto the front. And also you got this thing here, which could actually be used as a handle like that. I haven't used that a ton, but you know, if you're grabbing this from the car, you just want to grab this, take it out to your campsite, something like that, then it's pretty cool. And that's pretty much it from an exterior point of view. If we just take a look at the harness system on the back here, and before I forget, actually, just because I haven't used it that much, with a water bladder kind of trailing on from Patagonia's kind of outdoor with this bag, is there's actually a water bladder pass through, as you can see up there. Sits into the back, which I'm using as a laptop sleeve, but you can pop a water bladder in, comes out through, you can tuck it in between here, and you're good to go. So definitely have made this with the kind of outdoor adventures in mind. But I've been using it as a kind of urban EDC bag, and it works pretty well as both, to be honest. Quite a versatile bag. Then when it comes to carry, we've got nice shoulder straps here, pretty much what you would expect and like to find on a 25 litre bag. You've got a sternum strap, which you don't always see on 25 litre bags, and that's nice. It can just secure it a little bit better to your body, definitely improves the carry. And yeah, shoulder straps, really nice padding. It's a really comfortable bag to carry overall. And the back padding, even though there's not a ton of ventilation, maybe this back panel might help a little bit in the middle here, but really nice padding, and it's a pretty comfortable bag to wear overall. Definitely not too shabby then. We will just pop it back over to the front. As you can see on the right hand side here, we've got a water bottle in the water bottle side pocket there. Pop that down there. And then we've also got one on the other side. Now they are stretchy. You can fit numerous sizes of water bottle in there. They're not the most secure. Obviously, if you've got a really big one, it stretches it out, but they're not crazy deep. If you've got like a big 32 ounce, it's gonna pop out a little bit. It's gonna be secure, and they are pretty solid water bottle pockets, but just know that they're wide, not crazy deep, and they're stretchy. So, you know, stuff could maybe jostle around a little bit, but overall, pretty good side water bottle pockets on both sides there, and they helped add the aesthetic of the bag, I think, as well. Then we'll take a look at the kind of compartments on the outside. So we've got one at the top there that I'll just get into in a second. And we've actually got one down this front of the bag. And sometimes a bag will have one on the front or one on the top. This has both, and I've kind of just been using it to compartmentalize. So in here, I've just got some hand gel, and I have got a face mask as well. And you can pop, it actually covers this whole main area of the bag, so great for loads of different stuff if you want to use it. I just haven't been carrying anything that kind of fits this dimension, so I've just used it as, I know this is where like my face mask and stuff is, and this is where my wallet and keys are. So I'll zip that back up there, but really useful front pocket here. Really nice integration into the bag. Then, as I said before, we've got a front pocket here, or top quick grab pocket, I should call it probably. And in there, I've just got my wallet and I have got my keys. Now I've actually got this bag pretty jammed up. As you can tell, when you do that, the top pocket kind of eats up into the space a little bit, but I haven't found it too hard, and I've got my keys there as well. Usually I don't have this bag as full. I've kind of just packed it super full just to show how much it can hold, and it can hold a really decent amount of stuff. So put that back down there. Two really nice quick grab pockets on this bag. Definitely been utilizing them a lot. And I think it's about time to get inside the main compartment. So this is a top loading backpack. And it's this front kind of top area here. It's got this zipper. In fact, I'll just cover this top handle here is another way to carry it apart from the harness system, and this little front thing here. This is pretty good. You know, actually not that bad at, you know, if you want to hang this bag up or something, this, you know, nothing fancy. You're not going to carry it around with this, but it's a nice little addition for sure. Then moving back up, as you can see, it kind of zips around the top here and opens up like that. Now I'll just take this out straight away. I've just got a little hoodie in there, so it's getting cooler here in the UK. It's always good to carry around an extra spare hoodie if you need another layer. Then I've got a tech kit in the top there as well, which I'll just pop down. And then I've actually been carrying around with this bag my internal camera unit, which is pretty big, doesn't fit into all bags, but this one it fits really well. So I've had it when I've been out and around taking photos, so I'll take that out. It does fill up that space pretty well. As you can see, that's a pretty decent size. So I'll pop that down there as well. And yeah, 25 liters, decent size of a bag. You know, if you're carrying this around as a work bag or you're going on outdoor adventures, plenty of space. Now I will add, when it's not all the way full, it's a bit kind of crinkly and it kind of sags a little bit. So I'm not a crazy fan of what it is when you're not kind of packing this stuff out. So definitely be aware of that. They do different sizes and also different colorways of this bag as well. So take that into account, but just pick it back up here. We've got, as I said, that water bladder pass through here at the top, and in the back there, there's also, or the water bladder pocket, but I've been using it as a laptop pocket. Now this will fit 15 inch laptops. It won't usually fit a 15 inch laptop with a case, I found. I can't get my case in here as well. And I will add, it's not the best laptop compartment. It's not been made with kind of laptops specifically in mind, this bag, more so than, you know, less so than other bags, but they've obviously included it because it is a versatile bag. Now it's kind of slanted a little bit, if you can see that. And I've just, in all honesty, just had some troubles with being able to get it in. It's a little bit further down the pack, and this isn't ultimately useful for a laptop, where it is more so with a water bladder. So yeah, just note that, but it does hold 15 inch laptops, no problem. And then in the front, it's got another little pocket where I've just got a tablet. So I'll take that out there. Then on the other side, finally, there's a little internal pocket mesh, which is nice in there. It's got a little key latch. I'm not entirely sure why you'd want that in that compartment there. I haven't been using this one. It's just a little bit hard to access, in all honesty. So I haven't found, and because I've got like tech equipment in like a tech pouch in the main compartment, I haven't been, you know, haven't needed to use that, but there is a mesh internal pocket there. It lays flat if you don't use it, but it is there. And it's a nice addition, to be fair, just a little hard to access overall. And yeah, that's kind of the inside of the bag there. We'll zip it back up. It is a little bit hard to find stuff at the bottom. It does get quite dark in there because it's a top loading backpack. But yeah, that's pretty much it. The Patagonia Black Hole Pack, 25 liters. Head on over to packhacker.com for the full written review. where you can also find the best buying options that support our channel at no additional cost to you. We will see you in the next video.